Hello, this is lecture number 14 for the chapter sequence series, and we're discussing the miscellaneous exercise. And in the last lecture, we have done up to question number 14. So let us take the question number 15, in which it's given that the pth, qth, and rth term of an AP is ABC. So pth term is given as A, qth term is given as B, and rth term of an AP is given as C. And you have to prove that that is Q minus R into A plus R minus P into B plus P minus Q into C. You have to prove that it is equal to C. ये आपको prove करना है. तो simply find the values of A, B, C and put in the left hand side after to prove and you'll get zero. So the pth term of an AP, let the first term of an AP be capital A and common difference be capital D. So pth term will be a plus p minus 1 into d, qth term will be a plus q minus 1 into d is equal to b, and the rth term will be a plus r minus 1 into d is equal to c. Simply replace these values. So q minus r, the value of a is a plus p minus 1 into d, and R minus P, the value of B is A plus Q minus 1 into D and P minus Q into C, and the value of C is A plus R minus 1 into D, and you have to prove that it is equal to 0. So simple its question is now become, you collect the terms which is containing A and you collect the terms containing D. So the terms containing A is Q minus R plus R minus P plus P minus Q. So Q minus R plus R minus P plus P minus Q. This is the terms containing A. Now terms containing D will be Q minus R into P minus 1. Q minus R into P minus 1 plus here R minus P Q minus 1. R minus P Q minus 1, and here it will be P minus Q into R minus 1. P minus Q into R minus 1. Now open these brackets. See, it will easily cancel ho raha hai aapka. 0. And when you multiply and open the bracket here, you will also get 0. So it is equal to the right hand side. So this is the question number 15, in which the pth and rth term and qth term of AP is given as ABC, and you have to prove that this is equal to 0, where we have replaced the value of ABC and we have let the first term of AP as capital A and the common difference as capital D. Question number 15 this is. Now in question number 16, you read it, and it is given that some terms are given in AP and you have to prove that the ABC are in AP. Now what is given in 16th? It is given that A 1 upon B plus 1 upon C, B 1 upon C plus 1 upon A, C 1 upon A plus 1 upon B in AP, this is given, and you have to prove that ABC are in AP. So you know that first of all, you simplify it, it will be, if we take the LCM and add, it will be BC and A into C plus A into B. It will be A into B plus C into A upon CA, and it will be B into C plus A into C upon AB in AP. Now you know that you have done in the class 10th also, if we add, subtract, multiply, divide by the same number in the terms of AP, the terms will remain in AP. So I am adding 1 to all the three numbers, then the terms will remain in AP. So plus 1 I have added it, I have added 1 in the first term, added 1 in the second term, added 1 in the third term. The terms will remain in AP. If we add same number to all the numbers in AP, the terms will remain in AP. So if you add it, it will become AB plus BC plus CA upon BC, AB plus BC plus CA upon CA, ए बी प्लस बी सी प्लस सी ए अपॉन ए बी द टर्म्स आर इन ए पी, ए पी में टर्म्स हैं. नाउ इफ यू डिवाइड ऑल द टर्म्स बाय ए बी प्लस बी सी प्लस सी ए इट विल बी वन अपॉन बी सी वन अपॉन सी ए वन अपॉन ए पी इन द टर्म्स विल ए पी. That is, if we divide all the numbers by same number, that is AB plus BC plus CA, the terms will remain in AP. So this is, now if we multiply all the terms by ABC, the terms will remain in AP. If we multiply, divide by the same number, the terms will remain in AP. So it will be A, B, C in AP like this. So we have used the properties that if we add, subtract, multiply, divide with the same number to all terms of AP, the term will remain in AP. This is the question number 16. Now in 17, A, B, C, D are given in GP and you have to prove that the two expressions are in GP. So because A, B, C, D are in GP, so you can let the A as the first term, B as the second term, C as the third term, and D as the fourth term of AP. When A, B, C, D are in GP, you always let that A is equal to A, B is equal to AR, C is equal to AR square, and D is equal to AR cube. And you have to prove that A ki power n plus B ki power n, B ki power n plus C ki power n, C की पावर n प्लस D की पावर n इन GP. GP में प्रूफ करना है. अगर किसी टर्म को GP में प्रूफ करना है तो इसका मतलब आपको स्क्वायर ऑफ द मिडिल टर्म, यू हैव टू प्रूव दैट शुड बी इक्वल टू A की पावर n प्लस B की पावर n इन टू C की पावर n इन टू D की पावर n, ये आपको प्रूफ करना है. तो सिंपली रिप्लेस द वैल्यूज ऑफ A, B, C, D in the left and right, they both will be equal to each other. So put the value of A, B in the left hand side, which is equal to A r raised to power n. C is A r raised to power 2 ki power n ka square. So it will be A ki power n, r ki power n, A ki power n, r ki power 2n ki power 2. You can take common A ki power n, r ki power n, aap common le sakte hain, to 1. और यहाँ पे ए की पावर एन, आर की पावर एन कॉमन लेंगे तो आर की पावर एन बचेगा और इसका स्क्वायर. सो दिस कम्स आउट टू बी ए की पावर टू एन, आर की पावर टू एन एंड वन प्लस आर की पावर एन का होल स्क्वायर. दिस इज द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. नाउ आई विल प्रूव द लेफ्ट एंड राइट हैंड साइड इज ऑल्सो इक्वल टू दिस. तो राइट हैंड साइड में रिप्लेस करिए, ए की जगह तो ए है, बी की जगह कितना ए की पावर एन ए आर है, C की जगह ए आर स्क्वायर की पावर आपका n है और D है आपका, दिस इज ए आर क्यूब, ए आर क्यूब की पावर n. तो टेक कॉमन, यहाँ पर आप a की पावर n कॉमन ले सकते हैं तो 1 प्लस आर की पावर n बच जाएगा. यहाँ पर a की पावर n और r की पावर 2n अगर आप कॉमन लेंगे, देखिए a r की पावर 2n और r की पावर 3n है, तो आपके पास क्या बचेगा यहाँ पर, या आपने पूरा कॉमन ले लिया तो यहाँ पर 1 प्लस आर की पावर n बचेगा. यहाँ से 3n में से 2n ले लिया, r की पावर n. सो इट्स कम्स आउट टू a की पावर n इंटू a की पावर 2n, r की पावर 2n और 1 प्लस आर की पावर n इंटू 1 प्लस आर की पावर n इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर. सो ये आपका राइट हैंड साइड है, ये आपका लेफ्ट हैंड साइड है, दोनों एक दूसरे के इक्वल आ गए लाइक दिस. सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन नंबर 17 of your miscellaneous exercise. Sit. Those who have done, you can read the question number 18, which is given that if a and b are the root of the given equation x square minus 3x plus b and c square, C and D are the roots of the second quadratic equation where A, B, C, D are in GP. You have to prove that Q plus P upon Q minus P is equal to 17 is to 15. That is the question number 18. So when it is given that A and B are the root of first equation, a and b are roots of the equation. Now the equation is x square minus 3x plus p equal to 0. ये आपके रूट्स दे रखे हैं, तो आपको पता है सम ऑफ द रूट्स क्या होता है. सम ऑफ द रूट्स होता है माइनस बी अपॉन ए विच इज इक्वल टू 3, और प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द रूट्स होता है दैट इज ए इंटू बी इज इक्वल टू सी अपॉन ए दैट इज पी. सो दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ ए प्लस बी एंड ए इंटू बी. सिमिलरली इट इज गिवन दैट सी एंड डी आर रूट्स ऑफ द इक्वेजन. इट इज एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 12x प्लस क्यू इज इक्वल टू 0. तो अगेन द सम ऑफ द रूट्स विल बी माइनस बी अपॉन ए विच इज इक्वल टू 12, एंड प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द रूट दैट इज सी इंटू डी इज इक्वल टू सी अपॉन ए दैट इज क्यू. ये हमारे पास फोर इक्वेशन आ गए. नाउ because a b c d are given in as given as in gp, so you can let that a is equal to a, b is equal to ar, c is equal to ar square and d is equal to ar cube. ye aap let kar sakte hain this. now because it is given that a plus b is equal to 3, so when you put the value of a and b here, you will get a plus ar is equal to 3. Similarly, c plus d is given is equal to 12, so you can put the value of c as c is how much? C is ar square plus d is ar cube, which is equal to 12. So this you can put the value of in a plus b is equal to 12 and a plus b is equal to this. Now when you divide it, divide them, a 1 plus r upon a r square, that is 1 plus r is equal to 3 upon 12. When you divide them, aap inko divide kariye. So by dividing it, you will get the value of r square इज इक्वल टू 4. सॉल्व करने पर आर स्क्वायर की वैल्यू आपके पास 4 आ रही है. नाउ व्हाट यू हैव टू फाइंड, यू हैव टू फाइंड द रेशियो एज क्यू अपॉन पी अपॉन क्यू प्लस पी अपॉन क्यू माइनस पी. तो रिप्लेस द वैल्यू क्यू एंड पी. क्यू इज व्हाट इज क्यू, दिस इज सी डी, एंड व्हाट इज पी, इट इज पी इज ए इंटू बी. So a into b, when you replace these values of c, d, a, b, you will get this c is ar square, d is ar cube, and a is a and b is ar. So you will get as r raised to power 4, which is r square ka square. This is the value of q upon p, which is equal to 16. Which is equal to 16. So q upon p is equal to this. So q upon p is coming out to be r square is 4, that is 16, and you have to find the value of q plus p upon q minus p. So use companando and dividendo, you will get 16 plus 1 upon 16 minus 1, which is equal to 17 upon 50. So this is really a good question, and you have to use your brains to arrange these terms and obtain this ratio. It is a question number 18. Question number 18 it is. Now in question number 19, you read it. In 19 it is given that the ratio of arithmetic mean and geometric mean of the two numbers a and b is m upon n, and you have to show that the ratio of these numbers is the given expression. Now what is given in question number 19? You see it. It is given that the ratio of the arithmetic mean and geometric mean of the two numbers a and b is m upon n, and you have to show that a upon b is the given expression, which is m plus root m square minus n square upon m minus under root m square minus n square. So the two numbers are a and b. The arithmetic mean of a and b is a plus b upon 2, and geometric mean of a b is this. So ye hume given hai. So this comes out to be a plus b upon 2 root a b is equal to m plus n. When you do the c and d rule, कमेंडेंडो डिविडेंडो, तो ए प्लस बी प्लस टू रूट ए बी अपॉन ए प्लस बी माइनस टू रूट ए बी इस विल बी इक्वल टू एम प्लस एन अपॉन एम माइनस एन। बहुत बार आप सी एन डी रूल यूज हो गया है। ये किसका होल स्क्वायर है? दिस द होल स्क्वायर ऑफ रूट ए प्लस रूट बी एंड दिस इज द होल स्क्वायर ऑफ रूट ए माइनस रूट बी विच इज इक्वल टू एम प्लस एन अपॉन एम माइनस एन। दिस इज द होल स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस। नाउ व्हेन यू रिमूव द स्क्वायर फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, व्हेन यू रिमूव द स्क्वायर फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड यू विल गेट दिस एज रूट ए प्लस रूट बी अपॉन रूट ए माइनस रूट बी इज इक्वल टू रूट एम प्लस एन अपॉन रूट एम माइनस एन। यू विल गेट दिस, सी इट केयरफुली। नाउ अगेन यू सी एन डी रूल हेयर, तो सी एन डी रूल विल बी when you add both these in the numerator it will be twice root a, when you add subtract those two it will be 2 root ab, root m plus n plus root m minus n in the numerator and root m plus n minus root m minus n in the denominator when you using the this c and d rule. Now squaring both the sides because you have to find the value of a and b. When you find the whole square of this, a square plus b square plus 2ab, you will get m plus under root m square minus n square, and you will find the whole square of this, a square plus b square minus 2ab, you will get m minus under root m square minus n square. This is the ratio you have to find, that is the ratio between the number is m plus under root m square minus n square upon m minus n under root m square minus n square. Some good calculations there. Two times we have used C and D rule. We'll discuss in the next lecture the next question. Thank you.